drive systems with AC motors are more and more popular. We meet them everywhere, not only in factories, but also trams or electric cars, airplanes, etc. For this reason, it is very important that such systems are safe and allow to maintain continuous work even if some faults occurs. Because the stator current measurement is necessary for precise control of the AC drive system, current sensor fault tolerant control are increasing popularity in the recent years. However, this issue requires many scientific research related to the fault detection and compensation methods. As well as to ensure the most accurate estimation of the stator current under fault condition to preserve the continuous operation of the drive till it can be safely stopped. In the presented operation, a stator current estimator called virtual current sensor has been proposed, which allows fast detection of a faulty sensor and a smooth transition to the control in emergency mode. In case of the outage of both current sensors in the drive, it enables the current sensorless mode operation. As it is seen, the rotor speed is stabilized properly, despite the first of two current sensor fault, and next when the drive system operates in current sensorless mode. The rotor flux is stabilized all the time despite the damages of the consecutive current sensors. The tests were carried out for two different order of faults, first current sensor in phase A and next current sensor in phase B, and vice versa shown in the paper. The fault occurred in the steady state and, as can be seen here, epsilon coefficients very quickly exceeds the threshold value, established in both cases at 0.1. This allows very fast current sensor fault detection in phase A and next in phase B. Because of this, the alpha-beta components of the stator current is maintained by proposed virtual current sensor algorithm despite the fault of both sensors. My name is Michal Adamczyk, I am from the Department of Electrical Machines, Drives and Measurements at Wroclaw University of Science and Technology, and this is area of my PhD studies.